So, Marino.
You see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for, let's say, calling me to speak on this FinTech Summer Meetup. I would try, let's say, in a few minutes, let's say, to bring my previous experience being working with the banks for many years to see how the COVID actually affected the SMEs and what actually were some of the tools that actually either were available or been well built from the banks in order to help the SMEs to cater with the big increase of transactions that they are happening remotely and not with the physical presence. Okay, you remember this nice, let's say, graphic. We stay at home, then we say that we stay safe. And now I think we will come back to stay, I don't know what, but we are going to stay and listening what is happening with the COVID. Actually, the COVID make some things to change, and these are six, let's say, main facts that actually they came in as an result of the COVID, let's say, problem. Some of them I already mentioned from the previous pictures was that we moved from cashless, cardless, and contactless transactions, and we perform them more using this as a payment instrument. We move from face-to-face transactions to e-commerce. You remember that we have many problems with the supermarkets that you have to wait for 1 month to get some, let's say, goods. And the third thing that actually it's not something that is mentioned is the movement to go from, let's say, from using the banks and the central banks to go, let's say, to use the central banks in another way, meaning that there are many initiatives that they have to do with what we call it, say, CBDC, which is the digital currency, meaning that there are many initiatives that they are running from many central banks that we move from a physical cash to a digital cash, meaning that digital actually currency from the physical to the digital, meaning this will bring a new era, a new way that we would that we do transactions. Technologies like the distributed ledger, they will help us. So there are many initiatives from that. So this is what is going to happen and what we are going to see in the next, let's say, a year or years. There are already many initiatives from many big central banks like Bank of England, Bank of France. There are pilots that are running. So they are not something that is only the head of some, let's say, experimental, let's say, people, but it's something that is going to be reality. On the other hand, of course, there are some other things that they are coming. Of course, one is the new ways that the SMEs can take, let's say, some loans. There are many initiatives that they are coming from the European Union and also from the Greek government, and the Greek Development Bank actually is doing a lot of work on that. On the other hand, there are also some other initiatives that are coming, like the micro lending capability that also was part of some discussions with the previous years and now became reality. So we are going to have alternative ways of doing lending. We are going to have different ways of...
Have you moved forward with the slides or you have, because we're seeing the first one?
I move forward to the slide.
Okay, now we see the next one.
Okay, maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, okay, well, you can continue with the slide.
This is the slide that I'm seeing now, so I don't know if you see the same slide. I know that... Okay, I will see. Okay, in any case, because I don't see the screen. Also, the way of doing transactions is going to change. There are many changes on various payment processors. Actually, Marcos mentioned Wirecard, which was something that also produced a lot of problems to the fintech, let's say, ecosystem in UK, and not only UK, but mainly UK, that many banks there actually, or challenger or new banks, they are using the Wirecard services. And one thing that is going to happen, and this is what actually is happening, and not so much in the, let's say, in the Europe area, but it's happening, it's the merging and acquisition, let's say, process that is increasing. We see many fintechs that they are being bought from other big fintechs or from bigger, let's say, companies. We have heard that Visa has acquired Plaid, which is one of the biggest, let's say, aggregator in US and not only US. We're seeing other companies like, Tink or Salt Edge, or that also are aggregators that they actually have acquired, let's say, some other companies. They are a bit movement, let's say, regarding the fintech ecosystem and merger and acquisition that is happening. So you see the next slide?
Yeah, you can see it.
Okay. So based, let's say, on this is some results that I took, let's say, from a presentation from a Greek bank that actually make some calculations regarding the use of digital transactions. And what they noticed is that even if we have a lot of increase during the period that actually we have the lockdown, it seems that after that, they continue the digital transactions to be in a high volume, which means that the actually the way that the people that they are doing transactions has moved a lot from let's say physical to digital, and was not only the COVID, it was the that they actually discovered that there are alternative ways that they can do transactions. Of course, this also was increased due to other services that the government provided that somebody can do from his laptop or his let's say mobile phone, which actually increased the way that the people are using the technology. In Greece, that we have many people, unfortunately, that they are using that they are not using the technology. So they being educated as with they being educated after the lockdown that we have, and also the problem that we have in a couple of years before. In any case, it was something that actually changed and produced a different change of a different way that the people doing transactions. And to say that about that, there are many ways that actually contactless was the way that most of the people try to do transactions. There were many ways that somebody can do transaction. Was of course the cards, which always all of us we have in our let's say wallet. On the other hand, there were some other new ways that they are being promoted during this COVID era. Was the launch of Apple Pay from Alpha Bank regarding of using the Apple Pay for Visa and MasterCard cards. We have Eurobank wallet that also was launched during this COVID era. And of course, we have some other way that some other ways that we do transactions that they were there, but actually nobody knows them or they are not so popular. Is the payment that is available from National Bank of Greece. You have seen that in some of the events that the National Bank of Greece had made in the last years. And we have another alternative, which was iBank Pay, for the customers of National Bank of Greece, that also is there and actually can help in various ways the people that they do delivery. It's a way that you do transactions through a Bluetooth connection. It's not a let's say NFC, and also we have, of course, the Alpha Bank My Wallet, which is an NFC solution that also is available, and of course for the Alpha Bank cards, and actually was an alternative way to do transactions during this COVID area, COVID sorry period. Just some let's say more words to say is that the increase of transactions actually was mainly on the entertainment, of course on tertiary and hobbies, and of course on the food and beverages, which actually was the main ways that people they try, let's say, to do their change their living during the lockdown period, which of course it continue because they still get use of seeing Netflix or something like that, so they continue seeing Netflix, and of course they continue spending more time at home and not, let's say, going out, so they are still let's say this increase of volumes be there, and we hope that it will change in the next months, of course, if we don't have a new lockdown. And to say that in order to help the SMEs to do more transactions that they have to do with actually e-commerce, there are various ways that actually they are already available. We have PayPal, that they have the scan, pay and go capability that is available, and it's free until the end of September without any cost. So somebody can do easily with a scan of QR code, and if it has a PayPal account, can do a payment. We have Iris, which is a system that is already available for most of the banks, and actually is a system that you can do instant transfers between, let's say, accounts. And this is based on, let's say, on service that is available from all the banks, and it's included in most of the wallets or mobile banking applications that the banks have. So you can pay the other guy with just knowing his mobile number and his VAT. So
Marino, if yes. We could go to because we don't have enough time left for.
Okay. And finally, we have some other alternative way of doing, let's say, transactions. It's the payment links. It's a new way that was actually launched from different banks that allow people to do e-commerce transactions without having, let's say, a shop. With a smart way that you send through an email or through SMS a URL link, and the people that actually is buying things, they can press that and go and pay using their cards. And this is available from some banks and some alternative, let's say, processors. This is an alternative way that SMEs can use in order, let's say, to perform payments. Because we don't have time, this is what I have to say. Thank you for your time. And sorry if I took longer than expected.